ले जाए जाने कहाँ हवाएं हवाएं ले जाए तुझे कहाँ हवाएं हवाएं बेगानी है ये बागी हवाएं.
Hi, today we are going to learn about DLVO theory. First, we'll see what do you know this DLVO. This is the name of four scientists who coined this theory. These Derjavi, Landa, Weibe and Warwick. So we'll see what this theory says about. To say in a short form, this theory relates charge on the particle and distance between the particle. How it relates, what is the relation, we'll just see here. Now assume graph, okay. Let's say y-axis, x-axis. So y-axis represents potential difference and x-axis represents distance. Distance between the particles. Assume a graph where x-axis represent distance between the particles and y-axis represent potential difference between the particles. Now, what are the possible interactions between the particles? We'll see what are the possible interactions between the particles. First we'll see those. And the first one is, what happens if the two particles, assume this has a two particles, what happens if the two particles are having same charge? What happens? Obviously they will start repelling each other. So what happens when they have same charge? Two. What happens if these same two particles are having opposite charge? What happens? Obviously they will start attracting each other. So what happens when they are having opposite charge? They will start attracting each other. So third possibility is, what happens when the particles having same charge brought together? The fourth one is, what happens when the particles having same charge in that system, we are going to add electrolytes. Okay, particles are having same charge and electrolytes are added. So there are four possibilities between the two particles. One is, what happens when the particles are having same charge bound together? What happens when the particles are having opposite charge brought together? What happens when the particles are having same charge brought together by force, means fully, okay, they should contact each other. If they are brought too much close, what happens? Okay, the fourth one is, what happens when the particles having same charge in that system, I am going to add electrolytes. We'll see this. Okay, the first possibility, what happens when the particles having same charge brought together? So obviously their repulsive potential increases. This is represented by potential repulsion. So particle, one particle is here, another particle is here. What happens when the particles having same charge brought together? Their repulsion between them increases. I'm representing that as Vr. The second is, what happens when the particles are having opposite charge brought together? Obviously their attractive potential increases. This is represented by potential attraction. So in this y-axis, just assume when I go to the positive side, it is repulsive potential, and when I go towards negative side, it is attractive potential. So when the particles are having opposite charge brought together, attractive potential increases. Obviously they are having opposite charge, they will attract each other. So we'll see what happens when the particles are having same charge brought to too close. So what happens? Slowly, when you bring the particles which are having same charge closely, their repulsive potential increases, goes to the maximum, then they start attracting each other. So in this curve, we represent this as potential maximum, and this is called as primary minimum. We'll see what happens. So the third possibility, particles are having same charge, they brought too close to each other. What happens? Okay, when I bring particles having same charge together, what happens? Their potential, repulsive potential will increase, reaches to the maximum. Then if I go beyond this distance, their attractive potential increases. So you can ask me how it is possible. Okay, just assume two particles. There will be a atoms on the surface of the particles, those atoms have some orbitals. Okay, when you brought these two particles, even though they are having same charge, if you brought them too close to a distance, this much distance, see here the distances, okay, you brought to this distance, what happens? They are so near, so their orbitals start overlapping each other and they will form a strong bond between them and they get attracted strongly towards each other. It is impossible for them to get separated. This can be explained by formation of hard cake in terms of deflocculated suspension. In deflocculated suspension, the hard cake formation represents your primary minimum. Primary minimum is the minimum distance where they start forming hard cake. But why it happens? Even though they are having opposite charge, if you bring the particles too much close, their orbitals will overlap and they will form hard cake. That was represented the primary minimum. Okay. And this potential maxima, at this distance, they will have maximum repulsion between them. If you go beyond this point, they start attracting each other. Now we will see what is the fourth point. The fourth point says, the particles are having same charge and electrolytes have been added in those systems. So what happens there? When I start adding electrolyte, at this distance, the particles exhibit attractive force. See, the graph is going below. So I said, if you go below, that is attraction. If you go above, that is repulsion. So the particles are exhibiting attractive forces here. This we call it as secondary minimum. So secondary minimum is the minimum distance where the particles start forming aggregates. So there is a difference between primary and secondary minimum. We'll see what is this first. So the fourth point is, same charge, particles are having same charge. In this system, you are adding electrolytes. We call it as controlled flocculation. You are adding electrolytes in controlled fashion. So we'll see what happens. So particles are having same charge. Let's say they are having positive charge like this. Particles are having same charge. They are exhibiting repulsive forces between them. When you add electrolytes, let's say in a plus and Cl minus, when you add electrolytes, as they are having positive charge, the Cl minus is being attracted by those particles and the Na plus is being repelled. Because it is having same charge, it is being repelled and Cl minus is being attracted. Again, this Cl minus start attracting Na plus. They won't attract Na plus so much because already we have positive charge. So this what forms when you add electrolyte in controlled fashion to the particles. This arrangement occurs at a distance of 1000 to 2000 angstroms. The particles are at a distance of 1000 to 2000 angstroms. When you add electrolyte, when the particle comes together and the distance between the particles is 1000 to 2000 angstrom, what happens there? This formation is happening. So what is happening? We have positive charge particle. When you add electrolyte, this Na plus has been repelled because they are having positive charge. Cl minus has been attracted. And this Cl minus which is there, it starts attracting again Na plus. This whole system, if you try to move this system, this system hold together moves. The system hold together because as a single particle, single entity. When you try to move, this whole system moves together. We call this as flocs. This we call it as flocs. And we call this system as flocculation. This procedure we call it as flocculation. That what happens in the flocculation. So what is the difference between the flocs and the primary minimum and secondary minimum? Here also aggregation is happening. Here also aggregation is there. The only difference is in primary minimum, due to overlapping of orbitals, there attraction increases so much you can't separate those particles. They form hard cake. But in secondary minimum, these particles comes close. Okay, the particle come close. There will be arrangement of the electrolytes, added electrolytes, and this particle try to move together like this. So we call it as flocs. This is called flocculation. When you shake vigorously, the flocules will break and they act as individual particles. After some time, again they will come back and again they will form flocculates. That what happens in secondary minimum. This what is explained by DLVO theory.
The potential maxima is useful in stabilization of colloids because at this maximum potential, particles tend to stay away from each other. But primary minimum is the sign of instability. Secondary minimum is also sign of instability in case of colloids, but it is useful in the formation of flocculated suspension.
I hope you understood. Thank you.